When choosing a mouse, shape is extremely important for comfort and aim. And that's where the HyperX Pulsefire Surge got it right. But there is more to mouse choice than that. There's also weight, balance, buttons, capability, and so on. Now, before I get to all the details, there is one deal breaker for me. Here are three popular mice. Notice the space between the buttons. Now here's the Surge. A lot of mice do have this, but why is it a problem on this mouse? Well, I use an old school configuration with right mouse button as forward, left mouse button as fire. And when I press them down, the buttons actually hit each other. If you can't see that, here's a listen. I'm sure someone can modify these buttons so they don't do that, but I don't have the tools or the experience. Okay, with that out of the way, here's a tour and also a look at how much they got right. The top is a smooth plastic, which feels good on the palm. Both sides have a rubberized texture that feels really good. Combine that with the curves for grip and comfort, and this mouse feels really good for general use and in-game. It does flare out a little at the back. I usually prefer just a flat side, but this actually does feel good with the thumb, and also the little finger on the other side. That also means it's an ambidextrous design, but with buttons on the left only. There are slight comfort curves in the buttons, which could have been deeper, but still good. Overall, it's just a great shape. I hope they continue to work with this one, because it should suit a lot of people. It will most likely depend on the hand size. So at the fingers, it's about 5.9 cm, 12 cm long, and the height is 4 cm or 1.6 inches. Gradual slope on the buttons, highest point toward the back. This actually feels pretty good in palm grip for me. So it could suit hands up to 18.5 cm in palm, claw would be up to 21 cm, and fingertip above 17.5. Ideally though, I think it would be best in 20x10 cm hands, in claw or fingertip. For comparison, here it is next to the Abyssus and Death Adder. I wouldn't say it's a large or medium mouse, more in between the two. Now for the in-game testing. It's a 3389 optical sensor, so it should be a top performance. No problem rocket jumping around as usual. I can't make it spin out even moving it as fast as I can. And no spin out in the tilt slam test either. Zooming in, it tracks pixel by pixel and it does it smoothly. No acceleration as far as I can tell. And while here, no ghosting on the buttons either. The line test looks good, no issues that I can see. And in the latency testing, it scores about the same as the G900, so all good there. Now here's a listen to the clicks for quality and volume. Other than the problem with them hitting each other, left and right feel pretty decent, but there is a bit of a bounce, like an echo. It's hard to describe, so I'll just say they're decent but could be better. The wheel is low, a bit harder to press in, and it's smooth while also having steps. So while it could be a bit tighter, it's quite good as it is, for browsing and gaming. The side buttons are good, except I'd probably reduce the travel distance just a bit, and the DPI button is standard, but out of the way. Overall, I'm happy with them, but as always, they could be made better. Build quality wise, it seems solid. Tapping and shaking it, I don't hear any rattles. The cable is braided, smooth and 1.8 meters, and it's actually fairly flexible. No trouble in a mouse bungee. Where most competitive players might be let down is with the weight. 104 grams is a bit heavy these days. I would have liked to see this between 80 and 90, but that's personal preference, so some people might like it. The weight distribution feels a little more toward the back, but it's fairly in line with the sensor. The two large mouse feet you see here glide quite smoothly, and that's tested on a few pads. All good there. In the software, you have a fair few lighting options, and you can adjust the LEDs individually or together. You have a few presets, and can change the direction and speed. In performance, you can set up to 5 DPI stages, which go from 100 to 16,000, in steps of 50, and you can set a color for each to help you remember. You can also make macros, which picks up on mouse wheel, clicks, and keyboard. You can alter the buttons with keyboard commands, mouse, DPI, multimedia, and some other options. So all in all, good straight to the point software with a fair bit of functionality given how basic it is. Here's a look at the lighting in action, and I plugged it into another computer, and it didn't seem to remember my settings, so you probably need software for this one. Now some highlights while I give my conclusion. Wow, what an improvement. HyperX really stepped up their game for this mouse, way beyond my expectations. They have pretty much everything right, and maybe most people won't be affected by the mouse button issue. It just affected me a lot because I have two major commands on them, forward and shoot. That said, that does need to be fixed. Other people might not mind the weight, but if they just fix the problems I've mentioned, I might have actually put this in the top 10, because the cable, feet, sensor, shape, materials, performance and more is up with the best. So it's a great mouse, but it still needs some work, and at this rate, we might be seeing HyperX in the top 10 very soon. I actually played quite well with it, despite it being a bit big for me. Definitely looking forward to more mice from HyperX in the future. So big thanks to them for sending it out for review, and if you want to help support the channel, I'll leave some links in the description. Subscribe, like and share this video, and I'll catch you in the next.